Thank you to Intego for sponsoring this video. I'm Andrew Edwards, and you're watching Gear Live. This fall, Apple is set to release its next major version of its desktop operating system, and they're finally taking it all the way to 11 with macOS Big Sur. In many ways, Big Sur is the biggest update since the original release of macOS, since it will also run on the all-new Apple Silicon processors. And in turn, it will support running iPhone and iPad apps right on the desktop on Apple Silicon computers. However, in this video, I'm gonna go over the 5 major features that macOS 11 Big Sur will bring to everyone, regardless of if they're running on Intel or Apple Silicon Macs, starting with the all new design. When you update and log into a Mac running Big Sur for the first time, you're greeted by an all new updated design just about everywhere that you look. The dock has newly designed app icons that more closely match what you see on iOS and iPadOS, new translucent windows and menu bar, redesigned control center, and even the new widgets that we see in iOS 14 can be found in the Today View Notification Center. It still feels like the Mac, but with a new, fresh design for 2020 and beyond. Up next, let's talk about an update that a lot of Mac users have been waiting for a long time. Messages. In macOS Big Sur, Messages finally gets parity with the Messages app you'd use on your iPhone or iPad. Up until now, Messages on iOS had extra features that weren't supported on the Mac. Things like built-in Memoji, message effects, iMessage apps, pinned conversations, and more will now be available in Messages in Big Sur. And that includes new features like threaded messaging, mentions in group chats, Memoji and Memoji stickers, trending GIFs, and more. Next up, let's talk about what's new in Safari, Apple's web browser. If you weren't aware, Safari is the fastest desktop web browser, and not only does it lead in speed, but also in power efficiency when compared to Chrome and Firefox. This year, Apple has made Safari even faster while adding one huge feature to get even more people to use it. When I ask people who use a Mac why they don't use Safari, the number one response that I get is that they use Chrome instead because of the extensions. And I get it. Chrome extensions add a ton of utility to the browser. Well, in Big Sur, Safari will support the same extension architecture, which means that Chrome extension developers can easily make those same extensions available in Safari as well. Apple will also be adding a new Safari extensions category to the Mac App Store to make them easy to find. Safari also gets a customizable start page, so you aren't just looking at a blank canvas when you open a new window or tab, including the ability to add a background image as well. Tabs are updated with full color favicons and hover over website previews. There's built-in translation for 7 languages and a brand new privacy report feature where Safari will use intelligent tracking prevention to identify trackers on websites that you visit and prevent them from profiling you and following you across the web. You can even get a full report on any web page to see how many trackers Safari prevented. And speaking of protecting yourself on the web, I want to give a big shout out to this video's sponsor, Intego. Intego makes the Mac Premium Bundle X9, which is a complete Mac protection and security suite. The Mac Premium Bundle X9 contains 5 apps, including antivirus, firewall, backup, and more, all of which keep you and your data safe in a world where over 40,000 variants of malware and adware targeted the Mac in 2019. Visit the link in the description below to save 50% off the cost. That's half off of Intego's Mac Premium Bundle X9. And thanks again to Intego for sponsoring this video. Okay, up next, let's talk about the big changes Apple has made to Maps in Big Sur. In 2019, Apple released an entirely rebuilt from the ground up map, and in Big Sur, they add a bunch of extra functionality. If you drive an electric vehicle, you'll be able to get driving directions that take into account the need to stop to charge up. Cyclists can get directions optimized for biking, which will give information like elevation changes, how busy a street is, and when they might encounter stairs along their route. There are also new city guides that will help you explore a city, recommending things to do, places to eat, and more. You can even create your own guides and maps and share them with others. And last on my list of the major features you'll find in macOS Big Sur is background system updates. Now, Apple didn't really talk about the new system update feature for Big Sur, but I'm actually very excited about this one, so much so that I'm mentioning it here, as well as in my other video about the features Apple didn't have time to go into at WWDC 2020. So you know how when there's a new software update for your Mac, you have to download it, then reboot, and then wait about 30 to 45 minutes for your Mac to be usable again while the update process takes place? Well, macOS Big Sur speeds up this process substantially by taking care of incremental updates in the background while you work. This means that when you reboot to apply an update, the majority of the work has already been done. This makes it much easier and way less of an annoyance to keep your Mac secure and up to date. I know so many people who delay updating simply because they see it as an inconvenience, so it's great to see Apple tackling this one in Big Sur. Now, as I mentioned, I do have another video I'm working on giving you a look at the features in macOS Big Sur that Apple didn't have time to go over during the WWDC keynote. If you wanna see that one, be sure to hit that subscribe button down below along with the bell notification so you don't miss anything in the future. Thank you so much for watching this one. As always, guys, I appreciate your support. I'm Andrew Edwards, and I will catch you in the next video.